Let's go back to the calls.
Kevin.
Marjorie?
Kevin in Boston. Thank you for calling, Kevin.
Hi, Kevin.
Hi, Kevin Peterson. Good afternoon.
Kevin.
Mayor Walsh.
Hi, Kevin.
Hi, Kevin.
Good afternoon. Mayor Walsh, just a quick question and then a statement. Are you aware that I am on a hunger fast and at Faneuil Hall in front of your office?
I heard it starts Monday.
No, it started last Monday.
You should explain why, Kevin, for people who don't know. Explain why you're on a strike, please.
I certainly will. I just wanted to ascertain this, as to whether he was aware. I am on a hunger fast because there is a great need, particularly within the black community, to re-identify Faneuil Hall. Peter Faneuil was a white supremacist, someone who owned slaves, someone who willed his slaves to his sister after he died. It is exceedingly clear that we should not have racist symbols sort of reflected in our public institutions, our public buildings, which Faneuil Hall is one of. I've committed myself to going into a fast because I am a minister. I have a master's degree in theology. I'm going through a PhD program in theology. Part of my ministry, Mayor Walsh, is to engage in the public around the issue of race. Now, I've asked you a number of times, beginning 3 years ago, to engage in a conversation around racist symbols being reflected in our city. Now, I understand that you are saying that if we change the name of Faneuil Hall, nobody would know who Faneuil was. Well, that may be true, but people will know what white supremacy is. We don't need the name of Faneuil Hall. It embarrasses black people. And I think you
hey, Kevin,
a couple
Kevin,
weeks ago.
Kevin, if I may, only because lines are full, I think your point is made, and obviously you want the mayor to respond, and we'd like to hear it too. So let me hold you for 1 second. Mr. Mayor, what's your response to what Kevin has to say about the renaming of Faneuil Hall?
Well, again, Kevin, I've known Kevin for a long time. And I think that I would suggest, Kevin, ask you when you do a press statement in the future, you don't call me stupid, you don't tell me to shut up, and you don't call me a racist. And I think that that's a very hard conversation to have when you're coming from that standpoint and you've known me for a long time, you know I'm not a racist, you know where my heart is, and you know that there's opportunities for conversation, and that's how I'll respond.
Kevin, thank you. Mr. Mayor, very quickly, though, you do support getting rid of the Lincoln statue. Why the Lincoln statue and why not Faneuil Hall's name?
What we're doing with the statue is the Arts Commission is having a meeting. We're trying to move it up. I think it's next week. They're going to have a meeting. They're going to make a recommendation on to take that statue down to talk about how we move forward here. And that's what we're planning on doing with that statue. That statue falls under the Arts Commission. I think on Faneuil Hall, I made a comment the other day, and I've talked about it, is that, again, I don't think we can erase history. And there's a big difference between having a statue in a park and having a building that has a historical value. The statue that we're talking about, the Emancipation Statue, was in recognition of, I believe it was for, in honor of President Lincoln, recognizing the work that he did. Again, when we did some more research into this, and I didn't know this, for people that want to know, the statue was paid for by freed slaves that paid for the statue. What I wasn't aware of is that they did not have any opportunity to design or pick the design of the statue. It was picked by white people at the time. What's interesting is that we are looking in the archives and we're finding that there might have been sketches that the freed slaves have done up on what they wanted the statue to be. So there might be a real great opportunity here, and our Arts Commission is working on that right now in the city.
Thank you. Max, you're in Newton. You're on with the mayor of the city of Boston, Marty Walsh. Hi, Max.